How's it going, everybody? Elephant Ninja here, and welcome back to another Terraria tutorial. This time, we're going to be focusing on crafting the legendary Ankh Shield, which is an amazing item that provides you with so much immunity to tons of stuff in the game. Basically, fire blocks, knockback, and of course, yeah, a ton of other immunities that these items are like literally required to help you make it. Which, okay, didn't mean to do that. Yeah, all the items required to craft it, they are all right here in my inventory. Yeah, basically, the five Ankh Shield, the five Ankh Charm materials, and the Obsidian Shield. So yeah, everybody should know how to make an Obsidian Shield. First of all, you need 20 Obsidian, like literally destroy 20 blocks where water and lava actually mix. And if you get 20 of that, you can make an Obsidian Skull. And you can also then go down in the dungeon after you beat Skeletron and gamble for some really big chances with the golden keys in the chest to get the Cobalt Shield. Basically, with those together, you have immunity to knockback and immunity to fire blocks, as well as two additional defense because of the base set pieces. Yeah, the Obsidian Shield is such an easy item to collect, and it's pretty hard mode. But a majority of these items that you have to collect for the Ankh Charm, however, are basically hard mode exclusive. I'll basically show you. So basically, we have the Blindfold. You don't need to craft it into anything, kind of think of it. Yeah, the Blindfold. It gives you immunity to darkness. And yeah, it's pretty beneficial for you to have this in order for you to make that Ankh Charm. It drops from Corrupt Slimes, Slimelings, Crimslimes, and of course the Dark and basically Shadow and Bloody Mummies, depending on what version you play. All of them drop the Blindfold. Yeah, basically I'll tell you them again if you didn't hear me first. First is Crimslimes and of course the Corrupt Slimes and Slimelings. And the Shadow Mummies and Bloody Mummies. So yeah, that's basically all the enemies that can drop this. And they're all hard mode enemies, so yeah. Take that with caution, what you will. Every single item for the Ankh Charm has a 1% chance to drop from each individual enemy. So if you're having a very hard time collecting this, collecting any of these items, my best preference is to make a world for expert mode, where at least the chance for them to drop increases by another percentage. So basically, it would be 1 in 100 for them to drop the item normally, but basically 1 in 50 chance for them to drop it on expert or master modes. Keep that in mind. Keep that in mind, guys. Alright, so yeah, the Blindfold. Immunity to darkness. You don't need any other materials to craft it into anything, unlike the rest of the Ankh Charm items. Alright, next up, we have the Armor Bracing. Now, the Armor Bracing, it requires both the Jar of Vitamins and, of course, the Armor Polish. Basically to get the Jar of Vitamins, it drops from the Corruptor, if your world is in hard mode Corruption, or the Floaty Gross, if your world is in hard mode Crimson. Yeah. Yeah, both of those enemies have a chance to drop the vitamins, but it's best to stick more with the Corruptors, because you can fight them in the Corruption anywhere. But, with the Floaty Gross, they only spawn in the Underground Crimson, so yeah, not very common you'll be able to find that guy. Yeah, basically the Jar of Vitamins offers you immunity to weakness. Which, of course, they also apply, so be wary with their attacks. Alright, and we also got the armor polish part of the armor bracing. It drops from armored skeletons, or if you've also beaten Plantera already, it can also drop randomly from blue armored bones in the dungeon. So, yeah. Pretty first dungeon item. Obviously, the armor polish gives you immunity to broken armor. Yeah. Pretty amazing debuff when countering the blue armored bones and the armored skeleton, because they both try to destroy your armor. Basically, reduce your defense by 50%, which is never good. And yeah, the armor bracing basically makes up for that part for the Ankh Charm. And yeah, that's basically how you get these items. Basically, to combine the armor polish and the vitamins, you have to combine every item that needs to be combined together to the Tinkerer's Workshop. Yeah, that's basically how you combine all these items together. Ugh. I don't know what this is. Ugh. This thing in my arm's really disgusting. Okay. Alright, let's move on. Alright, talked about the blindfold and the armor bracing. Next up, we have the medicated bandage. Now, basically, it is a combination of both the adhesive bandage and the bezoar. Yeah, basically, to get the adhesive bandage, yeah. Yeah, the adhesive bandage, it, drops from three different enemies, I believe. The anglerfish, the werewolf on a full moon, and, of course, again, if you have beaten Plantera, the rusty armored bones in the dungeon. Yeah. So, that's basically, all the different enemies you basically have to kill to get the adhesive bandage and stuff like that. And, of course, it gives you immunity to bleeding, because, I don't know, I guess that's what they thought about when making this game. I can't say I blame them. Bleeding is a pretty annoying debuff. It was a very good one that you could apply if you had the Tizana. Man, I loved using that sword. Like, bosses would be automatically destroyed. But, yeah, there's no weapons you can use that can apply bleeding. And only these three enemies do now. Which is kind of a downgrade from 3DS. Or, not from 3DS. Maybe from 3DS and also old-gen console. Because that's where the Tizana was. Alright. Basically, that's how you get the bandage. You kill a werewolf on a full moon. They have a chance to drop that. As well as the anglerfish or the rusty armored bones. Alright, now we also got to the next part of the medicated bandage, which is the bezoar. Now, basically, to get the bezoar, you have to kill a moss hornet or a toxic sludge in hard mode. But, depending on any difficulty, you can basically collect it from a hornet as well, a regular hornet. Which is absolutely amazing. Because, yeah, the bezoars are pretty difficult items to come by in normal Terraria survival. Man, and if you do manage to get one, the immunity to poison really comes in handy. Especially when there's some dart traps that shoot arrows that deal poison. Or when dealing with the hornets that can also give you poison. Yeah, it's pretty simple and... yeah, definitely... definitely useful as well. Get in the bezoar. Yeah, it gives you immunity to poison. And yeah, you can combine that together to give yourself immunity to both poison and bleeding when making the medicated bandage. Alright! Now with all that out of the way, let's get to the next one. Yeah, next up is the two items that make up the Counter Curse Mantra. The Nazar and the Megaphone. Now basically to get the Nazar, you have to... basically collect it from a lot of those shadowy cursed enemies that come from basically the underground areas. So basically in the dungeon, you have to collect it from the cursed skull or the giant cursed skull even if you want to on that version. And also, yeah, the Crimson Axe, the Cursed Hammer, and the Enchanted Sword. All of them have a chance to drop a Nazar, which gives you, of course, immunity to Curse, which is very, very useful. Because Curse prevents you from doing anything. But, basically prevents you from doing any attacks to the enemy. Which, in my opinion, is a pretty annoying debuff. Thankfully, though, you will be able to get past that once you do get the Nazar that drops from, basically, these enemies. The Cursed Skull, especially if you play in pre-hard mode. Yeah, basically, the Hornets and the Cursed Skull are the only two enemies that drop the Ankh Charm items. Basically, no matter what mode you play it, like pre-hard mode or regular hard mode. They're just more common in pre-hard mode because they're weaker enemies, you know? Yeah, you can basically get both of those items no matter what mode it is. But it's pretty rare and very hard to do on regular hard mode, so. Yeah. It would be the best idea to make an expert pre-hard mode world, in my opinion. Because, yeah, percentage rates for items go up by, like, an extra percentage, I believe, for these items. Alright, and the second part of the Counter-Curse mantra is the Megaphone. Now, the Megaphone, it is a pretty interesting item. It gives you immunity to the silence debuff, which basically prevents you from using any magic items. And it can drop from the Pixie, as well as the Green Jellyfish, the Shadow Mummy, and, of course, the Bloody Mummy, like I've said before. Somehow, those same enemies that can drop the Blindfold can also drop the Megaphone, which is absolutely insane. Yeah, not much to say about that, but, of course, the Megaphone gives you immunity to silence, and... yeah, the Nazar gives you immunity to curse, and when you combine them together, it makes the counter curse mantra for the Ankh Charm. Alright, and finally, the last part you need for the Ankh Charm is the plan, which can be made by collecting both the Trifold map and the Fast Clock. Alright. So basically, to get the Trifold map, you can basically get it from basically the Light Mummies, from Giant Bats, and even Clowns, which are really scary. Yeah, thankfully though, Clowns only appear in like a hard mode Blood Moon, but other than that, they're pretty rare enemies to come by, so if you're able to get a Trifold map from that, then you're lucky, dude. You're absolutely lucky. Yeah, the Trifold map. It is, it gives you immunity to confusion, and if you don't know, what confusion as a debuff does, it basically reverses your controls, which is not a very satisfying debuff, I tell you guys. It was more annoying than it was, like, ignorable. Like, wow, I did not like the confusion in the slightest. Like, reversing of controls, dude. And it basically happens on contact whenever you touch the giant bat. Yeah, it's not really that good. So you might want to avoid the giant bat, or of course you'll get hit by confusion. Unless you have, of course, the Trifold map. Basically, because you'll then counter the effects of that. Alright, and the final item that you need for the Ankh Charm that also comprises the plan is the Fast Clock. Yeah, it's basically all in the title of this. The Fast Clock gives you immunity to slow. Yeah, immunity to slow. So basically, when you're attacked by a Pixie or, I guess, a regular mummy and a Wraith, those are the three main enemies that can drop a Fast Clock. So, if you're lucky with these enemies, you can actually get yourself a well-timed Fast Clock. See what I did there? Yeah, they also do try to give you slow on contact, so yeah, if you have the fast clock, you won't be slowed by them anymore. Oh man, that is just amazing, dude. Yeah, it is just so amazing. So basically, you can combine all of these together, all of these Ankh Charm items together to make these items, apart from the blindfold. You have to combine the jar of vitamins and the armor polish to make the armor bracing, the adhesive bandage and the bezoar to make the medicated bandage, the Nazar and the megaphone to make the countercurse mantra, and finally, the fast clock and the trifold map to make the plan. Once you have all four of those items, as well as the blindfold, you are well set to make the Ankh Charm. And if you have an Obsidian Shield, then go ahead and make yourself the Ankh Shield. That's basically what I'm about to be doing now, because I have all of these items. Yeah, basically we got Mirza's set. He's got the Menacing Obsidian Shield, the Arcane Blindfold, the Warding Armor Bracing, the Spiked Medicated Bandage, the Angry Countercurse Mantra, and the Spiked Plan. And, of course, for Shinobi, we have another Menacing Obsidian Shield, another Arcane Blindfold, a guarding Armor Bracing, a regular Medicated Bandage, a Precise Countercurse Mantra, and an Arcane Plan. Alright, and finally, for Sad Vibes, we have the Warding Obsidian Shield, the regular Blindfold, Jagged Armor Bracing, Medicated Bandage, Hard Countercurse Mantra, and of course, the Warding Plan. Alright, this is gonna be insane, you guys. I'm about to combine all of these together and work some amazing magic. Look at that! All five of those items turned into one Ankh Shield or one Ankh Charm each. So we have the Wild Ankh Charm, the Rash Ankh Charm, and the Hard Ankh Charm. I'm sure you can tell which ones are which. Alright, finally, the last thing we need to do is make the Ankh Shield, which gives you immunity to so many debuffs, as well as immunity to knockback and fire blocks. Alright, so we got Mirza's. Okay, then we got Shinobi's, and we got Vibes's. Alright, they all have Ankh Shields. So here's Vibes, which is Jagged. We got Shinobi's, which is Angry. And we have Mirza's, which is Precise. I don't know, these are pretty good Ankh Shields, but I feel like reforging one of these. Yeah, we definitely do need to reforge some of these. I'll go for Vibes's. Let's reforge this. Oh, Armored! That is better, dude. Armored is way better. Extra defense, dude. And for the Precise one, which is Mirza's, I think I'll change it to... Oh, it's another Armored? Okay! Are we about to make these all armored? If so, that's gonna be insane. Oh, wow, okay. Okay, I guess a lucky one will also do for Shinobi himself. Like, why not, dude? Alright, so now that we have the Ankh Shields together. Alright, we got Mirza's Armored Ankh Shield. We have Shinobi's Lucky Ankh Shield. And finally, we have Sad Vibes' Armored Ankh Shield. Yeah. Man, I'm so glad I could get that complete, dude. Man, also worked on getting the items for them as well. Yeah, I still need to work on some fishing tasks to get the sextants as well as the... I can't say weather radio because that's already there. Oh yeah, fisherman's pocket guides and sextants are what I'm missing for this. So, yeah. I also did get them some bone keys because, yeah, for an achievement, you do need the bone key. which can only be dropped from a Dungeon Guardian. And I did so much heavy work, you guys. Against the Dungeon Guardian on Expert Mode, he had 19,000 health, 9,999 defense, and I could only hit it like with 1 on normal hits and 2 on critical hits. So it was a long drawn out fight, but thanks to the Space Dolphin machine gun, I was able to clear that dude out and get 3 bone keys, as you can see here. Yeah, they always drop from Dungeon Guardians, no matter what difficulty you battle it. But of course, as the difficulty goes up, so does the health of these creatures, which is not always the best. Okay, I also did some extra... Let's see, I'm pretty sure some extra changes. Like, added some extra golden keys, gave all of them shrimpy truffles, because... Yeah, I felt like it would fit more as an amazing mount than, of course, the Blessed Apple. Yeah, I really hope you don't mind it, guys. Especially because I went against Duke Fishron on Expert Mode, and he always drops the Shrimpy Truffle when he dies in Expert Mode. And I went against him so many times, yet that dude just felt so easy to me. Some people might have a different story when it comes to Duke Fishron, because he truly is one of the hardest bosses in the game. But for me, I feel like that was really lucky, like, beating that dude so many times. Okay, like, beating Duke Fishron so many times. And, yeah, it was just amazing. Yeah, so basically, when I do get the Fisherman's Pocket Guides, and, of course, the Sextants as well, from the Fishing Quests, I will make another future video where I will make all 3 of these guys some extra phones. So, yeah. Yeah, go ahead and wait for that all you want. It's gonna be a pretty amazing video, because you do need a lot of items to craft the cell phone yourself as well. Just like with the Ankh Shield. I really hope this video helped out with people who wanted to make the Ankh Shield. And once again, yeah, we definitely made some new houses. We got Squidward's house and we got Patrick's house. Yeah, I know you guys definitely enjoyed seeing it on Creative Arts on Merz's server. Like, it was amazing. And my trophy wall is complete as well. Literally have every boss's trophy. Excluding event bosses, because in my opinion, they don't really count. Oh, man. I'm pretty happy to have, like, gotten so much done in this game. Man, especially getting the bone keys. Getting those bone keys, that might have been one of the hardest things I would have ever had to do. But I was able to do it, so, yeah, call me a god at this game if you want. Especially, like, risking my entire life just getting all 5, just getting some bone keys. From Expert Mode Dungeon Guardian, it was crazy. Yeah, it is crazy. So much defense, so you can only do like 1 damage or 2 in critical strikes. And, yeah, if this Dungeon Guardian does touch you, he will automatically kill you. And in order to summon in the Dungeon Guardian, you have to go, like, down in depth, basically down in depth where you can see where it says surface over there. Yeah, where you can see down here where it says surface. Yeah, basically, that's one of those things that do require, one of these materials to help you make the cell phone, so. Yeah, if you have the depth meter, then that's a very great indicator to basically tell you you're about to summon in the Dungeon Guardian, which is basically when you're at surface level 0 and you start to enter the underground areas. The Dungeon Guardian will then spawn, And basically, if you have a UFO or some other fast vehicle that you can drive and fly with, then the Dungeon Guardians will be pretty easy to take out. Yeah, for a beginner though, there's nothing you can do. You're basically dead. You have to basically get past, like, the Martian Madness, or basically go through, like, a Master Mode Pirate Invasion against the Flying Dutchman, or basically an Expert Mode fight against Duke Fishron or something. Because I'm pretty sure those vehicles might be the only things that can help you against the Dungeon Guardians, so... yeah. Yeah, that was a little bit off topic from the Ankh Shield. I'm sorry, guys. But yeah, you definitely know where to go for all those items, don't you? So basically, the Blindfold around Corruption or Crimson. Vitamins around Underground Crimson or anywhere in the Corruption. The Armor Polish, basically, Underground or Post-Plantara. Then we got the Adhesive Bandage, which is, of course, basically down in any watery areas around the world, even in the jungle. And, of course, during a full moon. And, yeah, Post-Plantara again. Yeah, then we have the Bezoar, which is like underground jungle to just simply underground. Yeah, that's where you can find that item. Alright, then we have the Nazar, which is underground Corruption Crimson Hollow, or of course in the dungeon. Then we have the Megaphone, which is basically around Hollow, around Corrupt or Crimson Deserts, I believe. What I should have also said about the Blindfold. And of course the last place to get the Megaphone is like down in watery areas in Hard Mode. Yeah, basically because of the green jellyfish. Alright, and then we have the Trifold map, which of course leads to Underground. Yeah, Underground in Hard Mode, basically. Then of course, Hallowed Deserts and the Blood Moon in Hard Mode. Yeah. Yeah, that's basically where you find that one. And finally, the Fast Clock, which is basically around Hollow, basically around Hard Mode Night, and of course, Normal Deserts. So yeah, basically if you're having trouble figuring out the entire map, I'll basically put a very big picture of it as soon as we get off this Terraria screen. Just gonna position myself in my pineapple house for a second. And yeah. Whew. Really hope you guys did enjoy. Here's the picture of the whole Ankh Shield chart. So yeah, if you have any questions or you need any extra help on getting the Ankh Shield, just let me know, okay guys? I'll give you some pretty good tips on my Discord if you want. Basically my Terrarian knowledge on my server, so yeah, really hope you guys did enjoy this Ankh Shield guide video. Man, this is about 30 minutes long. I'm sorry you guys if you didn't want to watch this for 30 minutes, but I feel like it's fine. Elephant slice that like button. Oh wait, that's not a slice. Elephant slice that like button, that's better. Subscribe today to join the Elephant Ninja Clan, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye, everybody.